Greetings and welcome back to another First Impressions. This time I'm a little late to the game, but we're talking about UI layers, flex panels, and everything that has to go with that inside of GameMaker. So this was announced, I think, like a year and a half ago and officially released a few months ago, it looks like. So I'm coming into this with very little knowledge, just a little bit of trying it out, but I do have a good bit of experience using flexboxes and panels in web development and UI development inside of software development in general. So I have some experience there, which is probably tainting my experience here because I hate front-end development, which is all of this flexboxing, making sure it fits in this size and that size. And well, let's jump into it and see how it looks like. So first off, what is it? Well, it's an entire new set of layers that go into your room that allows you to dynamically create user interfaces, GUIs. So this can be like a main menu. You could imagine an overlay for a camera, a mini map of some sort, an inventory. And what this is flex panels. They're called, flex panels or UI layers, what it lives in. So this entire one would be one UI layer for creating a pause menu effect. And you can see I was having some struggles here and there, even following along with the main tutorial. These are flex panels. You put assets or text inside of them. You presumably then can move them around and change them, and they will dynamically resize, because you can come into the main one, like this whole panel, and I could choose the direction and set it as a row and have it still actually mostly still look and function properly. There's a tremendous amount of options inside of here, and I am actually very impressed with how much they have going here. I don't think I'm a fan of it, but there is a lot here. So every single one of these, the UI layer has a whole set of options with padding. You go into the flex panels, you have the size you want and the minimum and the max. You have how much it's allowed to grow and shrink. You have the position. You've got all the flex properties you would expect. And the thing is, this is a really robust system, primarily because it's actually coming from Yoga, which is a engine designed to target web standards. So when you're using a website, it dynamically changes based on the size that you've got here. And in general, the web works really well in that regard. So you have this menu here, whereas when you go full screen, that menu pops open. And I've done all of this before, and it is an absolute pain in the butt. I hate this kind of stuff. This is all front-end development, is what it's called, when you have to make something look good and you have to center divs. And that's what this feels like. So the idea of a UI layer makes absolute sense. I've used UI layers in something like Godot. They are super robust, but you trade the simplicity of what GameMaker is for the complexity of super dynamic and complex and robust system like a UI layer that can handle basically anything you want, and then it takes forever to get into. Even on the coding side, right? If I jump over here, I was trying to follow and find some information. The manual has, hey, here's how you can create a node through code. And you basically pass in some JSON, or a lot of JSON inside of here. They have functions for all of those as well if you don't want to be using JSON. So you can do everything inside of code, which is fantastic, which makes it dynamic, so you can do it while your game is running. But I could not even figure out how to do something with this, right? I'm looking at the manual that they've got. This is how you make a flex panel. And then they say, now you can go and do something with all of that information. And it's like, what am I supposed to do? This is 40 new functions, with the flex panel properties having like 30 or 40 more properties that are not code completed, that you do have to have strings inside of here, which, I mean, you have to type out row as a string. That just, ooh, okay. But then you come in here and it says, hey, do this, and then with these examples, you can use the data from this with draw rectangle, but they don't even show you how to do that. And I don't quite understand why. It seems like this could be a really powerful system. They even have a fantastic debug overlay, which actually lets you see the properties of all of this. Like, this is so good, and the reason it's so good, again, is because it comes from web development. Right? If you've ever done any front-end web development, you can come into an inspector and you can come and click on pretty much anything inside of here, and you can see things like margin and border. This right here, I can pick an element and you can come in and actually see how this element works and where it lives inside of the flex panel and all of that stuff. And that's great. Wonderful. I hate doing it. I would want a game maker, a game dev UI layer to be so much better, to be so much easier. Just imagine you have something like this where you can drag and move around and actually visually adjust this, and then you can have a few settings over here to change what you want. And then you can alter that through code. That to me sounds way better. But if I come in here and I try to move these things around, I have no idea what this is going to do or how this works, because my flex panel is still here, but I've moved the element outside of it. And I would much rather have a much more visual experience when it comes to the UI layer, which this is not. They have a tremendous amount of options. Looks fantastic. I do not know how to use this. The examples out here, the only real one I could find was a year ago. And to me, figuring out a layout and writing out this just looks miserable. And I don't even see, I have not seen a real reason for it yet. If I could plop in an inventory that is scrollable, that I can add things to, and it has a flex panel so it automatically adjusts the size of every item and scales it down, that sounds great. I haven't seen anything like that. I'm looking through YouTube. There's two videos from GameMaker 3 months ago. There's nothing else on flex panels. Everything else is old. Everything else is doing menus and inventories in unique ways, like I've done myself. There's nothing on here about flex panels. Now, that's concerning. I was looking into it and I want to be able to make something about this, but legitimately, I don't know how. The manual does not give a good example for me to take and try something with. That article from a year ago, although it has a lot of code in it, the end result, like this, I don't see why it would be better. And then activating it and using it through code looks like a real pain in the butt. Yeah, doing your UI completely through arrays and doing it that way is a lot, but it also provides a lot of flexibility, and it's worked for many years now. And I think if they were going to improve and create something, they should have done it what I would realistically call the game maker way, because I don't understand what's going on here. But the first time I saw sequences, I understood what this was, and I was excited about it, because I understood that you could bring this in here, and I have a video editing background, and so I understand what these keyframes are, and that's awesome. That excites me. This does not excite me in the slightest. This fills me with Just depression. This is front-end development inside of GameMaker, and if I'm being honest, I probably will never touch this. Even in my games that I'm making now, I do not see a compelling reason to use this. I want to actually see some examples, because I am terrible at coming up with GUIs and UIs and front-end art stuff. Like, I don't know what would look good in a game or what would be nice that way, and I don't know why you would go through the trouble of having flex panel after flex panel, item after item that you have 24 options for where things can go wrong without a tremendous amount of reason to do it. Now, this is a first impressions, and that's what that is. Yeah. I hope that this gets better. I hope they improve this, and I hope that they put out some real examples with this. Because honestly, GameMaker needs some UI-focused stuff. And unfortunately, this is what we got. I might feel differently if they came out with a tremendous amount of extra, like, demos. But there's nothing here. There's nothing. And if they're working on something, it's been 3 months. It's been a year and a half. The only thing that I can think of is in these prefabs, they have a UI section. If we scroll down, this user interface, but it's a 0.1.5, and that's because if you try to do anything with it, it will just crash your game and you will never be allowed to open it again. And so I think they're working on it, but they need to put some things out, because honestly, there's a lot in the manual here, but it doesn't tell me much. Like this right here, they're just creating nodes over and over. And I think they tell me what to do with them, but I don't understand why there is not a specific flex panel drawing property. Am I supposed to just draw rectangles based on the property of something here? I think that's what it is, but honestly, I don't know, and I have yet to see it. Even the live stream that was put out, the live stream is just a long version of this video that they did without doing much at all in code. There's a little bit of code in the live stream, but very, very little. And so, yeah. First impression wise, I don't see myself using UI layers, flex panels, anytime soon. If you've got a project or a demo or something that I can check out that you want to show off, please leave a comment down below. Let me see it, show it off. Let's check it out together. If you can change my mind or you agree, let me know. I'd love to hear. But that's my first impression. Short and sweet, I hope. And this time, not very positive. So, there you go. But as always, keep making, keep learning, and I'll talk to you later.